On October the 31st, 1517, Martin Luther posted 95 big questions which he believed faced the church of his day to a local church door in Wittenberg, Germany. 500 years later, I decided to post 95 new questions, one a week, to the web, questions which I believe the church must face in the 21st century. Last week's Chalk Talk created loads of questions. So a huge thank you to everyone who's been in touch with me. I'm really sorry I can't answer everyone individually, but instead, over the coming weeks, putting your thoughts together, I hope to respond with something of my understanding of the various big issues that have been raised. Of course, real depth of insight is always discovered through discussion. So, as ever, all I can do is bring my understandings and leave you to do the thinking and have the conversations for yourself. And, as I always say, the really important thing about all those who seek to follow Jesus is that we do all this graciously even when we disagree. Why? Because each one of us is loved by God, not because we're right, but because God is love, and so loves and accepts us, often in spite of our views and opinions. So that's the only way to treat one another. Here's one of the most popular questions about what I said in Chalk Talk 56, and it gets right to the heart of the point. If God loves and forgives everyone and everyone gets to go to heaven, then what's the point of being a Christian in the first place? It's a good question. It's a really honest question. And it's a question that I hear often. But if I'm honest, I think that there's a thing behind the thing. It often sounds to me like the real unspoken question is actually a different one here. Are you really trying to tell me that I've been wasting my time with all this church stuff, this Christian stuff, for absolutely nothing? And that God loves everyone anyway? It's just not fair. In other words, I wonder whether for many this question disguises the fact that they've been taught that the primary reason for being a Christian is to avoid God's anger by getting saved and so guaranteeing a seat in heaven. When I was a teenager, I remember often being asked, if you were to die tonight, how do you know that God would accept you into his heaven? That, I was taught, was the point of giving your life to Christ, of becoming a Christian. But over the years, I've come to see things differently. Yesterday morning, I tweeted this. I'm not as bothered about going to heaven when I die as I am about bringing a bit of heaven to earth right now, and working to end the hell that countless people are forced to endure every day. I think that that's what Jesus meant when he asked us to pray, Our Father, your will be done on earth. As far as I'm concerned, living Christ's way is the best way to live life right now. And the emphasis of the message of Jesus is about life after birth, much more than it's about life after death. God's kingdom has been initiated through what Jesus has achieved. He's conquered death for himself and for us all. But for now, as we long for the day when he'll be acknowledged as Lord by the whole world, our personal challenge is to choose to live in sync with the way the universe is heading rather than the way it is. That's why the way we live right now matters. The decisions we make here and now really count. Our lives are precious, a precious gift. They're sacred, every moment of them. Our task is to live, to build God's kingship here on earth, to invest in what God's doing. And that's why, for instance, when the Apostle Paul, that revolutionary follower of Jesus, wrote to his friends in the city of Colossae, in what we now call chapter 3, he exclaims, therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another. If any of you has a grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. The way I see it, God isn't fair. The Bible never says that God is fair. The Bible tells us that God is love, and that is very different. Love is about undeserved grace, which in the end, everyone gets because God is the gracious and kind judge. But the question is, why miss out on living for Christ now? And if it's that good, why would we not want to tell everyone else about it? But more about that next week. So I'll leave you with the same question that prompted this talk. If God loves and forgives everyone, and if everyone gets to go to heaven, what do you say the point of being a Christian is?